Welcome to this week's edition of Africa Sideways, where we take the Mitsubishi Pajero Sport to the ultimate testing ground of the Cederberg in the Western Cape. We drop in at the lush and plush Kakakama Private Nature Reserve for all things garish and boyish as we dice the Mitsubishi against the Ranger to see who's the fastest down the Kakakama test track without crashing.
So we're getting deep into the Cederberg here, sort of territory that the Pajero really is at home with. Lovely high clearance here. I think this is pretty much a go anywhere off-roader. Fortuna better watch out, but Pajero is making a run at 435,000. Great value for money. Brilliant turning circle on this thing as well. You can turn it on a dime. Next time we get in the Mini Cooper, we're gonna have a turning circle competition, and my money's on this piece. You can feel the suspension's a bit truck-like, but if you're gonna go off-road, you don't want a NAMSY, PAMSY, all-wheel drive. You want something like this, under 400k, 500k, I beg your pardon. Probably the best serious off-roader on the market, Pajero Sport. Off to Kakakama Nature Reserve.
Kakakama.
We got a control freak director here. We go in there, we're gonna test their quad bikes out, we're gonna drink their beer, Africa Sideways style.
First Pajero prototype was unveiled at the Tokyo Motor Show in November 1973 as Mitsubishi aimed to take over the recreational SUV market that was dominated by Land Rover. In January 1983, the first Pajero made his debut at the Paris-Dakar Rally, taking first place in 1985. Only the third attempt.
I think I might have a bit of stroke in this town. I had my name done four times on the booking sheet. Come on, son.
You'll never guess where I am. The beautiful Kakakama Game Reserve in the Cederberg. 15,000 hectares of off-roading magic. Not to mention a wellness spa, pub, and lovely little braai facilities. Apparently the biggest ravine in South Africa, or second best, 800 meters to the bottom at the edge of the property here. Plenty to get stuck into. Quad bikes, we're gonna put the quad bike up against the Mitsubishi Pajero that we got here. That was a lovely shower. Here on the reserve, you got a well, they got solar power. This is a carbon neutral game reserve. Four-star lodge, let's see what the breakfast is like. Interesting enough, this is probably the only four-star lodge without television. Out in the bush, you don't need television, plenty to do. So this used to be a sheep farm 50 years ago. In the family, a family of winemakers from Paul bought the place, had sheep here, kicked the sheep out, turned into a tourist resort. Well done, Bruce. It's really one of the best retreats in the Cederberg, arguably in the Western Cape. Used to have Khoi San people living on here before they had their land reclaim junction put through court. So a lot of history here, rock arts, off-roading, quad biking, lovely pub through there. We're going to have a little shikha later. Oh, and the food is to die for.
Oh, I'm scrumptious. The chef came to say hello. Looks like a lovely little man. I think he's going to do the business on these bacon and eggs.
I've heard a lot about this breakfast. Let's get stuck in. That'll work. Under the bonnet here, you got the 2.5 litre turbo diesel.
Dakar heritage.
bulletproof. You get a million miles off this puppy and still come back for more.
You're really on top of the world here. Another great feature is the cup holders, numerous cup holders. When you're on the long road, you want to be able to put your Coca-Cola in a safe, convenient place. It's not going to fall over and get all over your pants.
And then for Doris Day, you can't drive properly. There's a camera on the back of the car here, which is a nice feature. Although I did find the glare was a bit of a problem for seeing what was going on.
So in typical Africa Sideways style, we don't want to just check out the wildlife, we want to race these quad bikes. So we're getting the assistant manager, Ruan, versus Greg Big Six Simpson, when it takes on the Pajero. Good set! Go!
There was one hell of a race, but I think I've got a better chance than the Pajero.
He's got no chance, I've got the Pajero.
Come on, go! Oh, a little bit slow off the mark, but we'll get him when the turbo comes in. 2.5, oh, hello. 70, 80. Coming up to 100. Put your back on the runway, I'm gonna give this to full go. 110. 120. I think we'll leave it there, ladies and gentlemen. Man your feet.
Hell of a race that, neck and neck. Quad bike had it over 0 to 40, 45 k's now, and the Pajero came steaming through. Only one winner here on Africa Sideways. Kakakama drag race on the airstrip. Pajero takes it all the way home to Cape Town.
Almost had it.
Whew. Quite a jump there, I'd say it's at least 30 meters.
I'm ahead of a club sandwich, this, ladies and gentlemen. Everything in this place has got meat on it, including the cereal. Proper chef. Old matey had a massage today. Could liken the Pajero to this sandwich. Tasty. Pretty meaty. Full of fruit. End of a beautiful day at Kakakama, given the Pajero a full workout. We've also given the dinner plate a full workout and the old Zonnebloom Merlot. So in closing, the Pajero, fantastic clearance, meaty car, very well made, extremely tough. On the negative side, you're going to be looking at a big fuel bill with this car. Any SUV with those big treads, going to get a little wet and wild. So we had a little tank slapper early on. I mean, I blame it on the active traction control. I mean, I had it, we were just getting the power on, and the power didn't come. The computer said, it's getting a bit wonky, but I'm gonna turn the power off, and into the bushes we go. Luckily, there were no rocks, and we just juiced it out of there, back down the runway, in your face, Africa Sideways.